Hey, Gixxer Man, 01 back out in the garage. Today we're going to compare some of the Harbor Freight hand tools to name brand hand tools from Channel Lock, Nipix, and Matco. So let's get at it. So I've got five different types of pliers sitting here. Some are cutters, some are pliers. What I've purchased is the Doyle. This is Harbor Freight's, what I'm going to call their premier hand tool line when it comes to pliers and cutters. They have Pittsburgh, and then they've got another brand, which is, I'm going to say, somewhere in the middle of these and the Pittsburgh hand tools. Nothing wrong with the Pittsburgh ones. They're okay. Build quality is not quite as nice as this Doyle stuff, but so what I'm going to compare to is I got a pair of Matco pliers made by Nipix, and then just a standard set of Matco needle nose pliers, and let's cut them open and see how they stack up. Okay, they're pretty tight out of the box, which most pliers are. Size wise, I'm going to say they're closest to this Nipix set. Of course, I bought these with the idea I wanted a pair with a long reach to them. And when I look at them, I'm looking to see that the cutter comes together all the way across, which it does. I don't see any daylight between the cutter. You don't really see any daylight through the jaws, and the tips of them come to completely close and have a nice machined finish out there on the end. The jaws look pretty nice. They're a cross hatch, very similar to this pair of Matco pliers, and like I said, they have a nice feel to them. There's no play, there's zero play in these things at all. And the printing on them is actually pretty nice too. Nice deep print. I'm going to say these are on par quality wise with these Nipix pliers, which is pretty surprising considering the price point. You know, I'm going to guess at least $30 for that pair of needle nose pliers, and these were, I don't know, $10 or $11 at the most. So so far, these needle nose, I'm gonna say, definitely stack up to my Matco stuff. So let's check out these. This is a pair of side cutters that I've had from Matco for a really long time. You can see there's quite a bit of patina, as some people say, on these pliers. They still got a good edge. I don't have any nicks in the cutting head on them. And they come together very nicely. Typical Matco tool truck quality tools. These Doyles, you know, there's no daylight between the cutting head on them. I will say this is a little longer handled set than the Matco, and I'm sure Matco makes a longer handled set of side cutters. These also have a nice print on them. There's zero play in them, so they're very stout. And I do like the extra leverage that I get from the longer handle on my side cutters. And I mean, they look to be good quality stuff here. So so far, I'm going to say that these Doyle hand tools are stacking up to any of my Matco stuff. Now, this is a set of cable cutters from Matco, or wire cutters from Matco, and I've put these things through it. They've cut stainless steel cable for winches. I've cut some pretty nasty stuff with these, so they've seen quite a bit of abuse. I've had to go through and sharpen the blades on them simply because nicked the blade cutting some heavy stainless cable. Now this set of cutters I think is probably more heavy duty than the Matco ones, in the simple fact that how large they are. You can see the size of the jaw there and the amount of leverage. Now, I will say these are pretty stiff, but I think that's something that'll work out as you use them. Probably wouldn't hurt to drop a little oil down in them, although it does appear to have some oil on them. But I'm going to say the way these are shaped that they're going to probably have more cutting power than my Matco, and that's simply due to the fact that longer handle and just the way the blade's shaped. These have worked pretty well for me over the years, but I have a feeling this thing here is going to be able to crush a much larger cable than what my old trusty Matcos do. Build quality's good. Like I said, no play in this at all. As a matter of fact, it's a little on the tight side, and I'm hoping that'll loosen up as we go along with it. I'll definitely add some oil to those to see if those open up. Next is a pair of slip joint pliers. Okay, these are my trusty old, these are channel locks. Probably a pair I bought off of the tool truck. Little bit of play in them, but these things are, I'm gonna say, we're probably looking at, I bet these are a good 25 years old. The blades no longer actually touch on the cutting portion of it, and it's a little different shape than the Doyle brand, but these things have worked pretty well. They also have seen some abuse. I'm gonna say the blade doesn't come together simply due to there's some wear and tear in the slip joint on these channel lock pliers. Something that I like about the Doyle brand, where this cutter actually just comes together and meets, the cutter in this pair of pliers actually overlaps. So if you get a little wear on the slip joint on this, your cutter's still gonna work. And the fact that the cutter, as it cuts whatever wire you're cutting, it pulls the wire back into the cutter even deeper. So that's a good design on those slip joint pliers. The fronts of them come together very nice. The front of it comes together very nice there. They meet up pretty good. Operation of the slip joint works really well. There's way less play in these than there is in the old channel locks here, but keep in mind, again, these are probably 25 years old. Next up is a pair of channel locks. These are fairly new, so this will be a good comparison to see how much play in my channel locks compared to how much play in these Doyle slip joint pliers. Ooh, these channel locks, while it's not a ton of play, there's some pretty good play there. And these Doyle pliers are actually tighter than the channel locks pliers. Again, the front of it comes together. It's machined pretty nicely. The slip joint operates very smoothly. The channel lock actually hangs up a little bit, and the Doyle pliers actually, it's like they beveled the front edge of that slip joint so that it finds its way into a joint or into the notch a little better. So I think I'm gonna say these Doyles have a little better, slightly better build quality than the channel lock. That really surprised me. But really nice build quality on those compared to the channel lock. And so that's five different pairs of pliers and cutters. Those, if you're looking to purchase some hand tools, I think I'm gonna buy a complete set of those Doyles just for the aesthetics of having all the same hand tools in my drawer. The quality on those Doyles is very, very good. Thanks for watching. Please click that like and subscribe. I hope this video helped you out if you're looking to make a decision on whether or not to purchase pliers there at Harbor Freight. We'll see you in the next video.